Yo, what it do, what it don't, what it will, what it won't. Trigger Lady T in the place to be.
Yo, what it do, man? It's your boy, Young Clova, one half of G-Side, man. And I'm sent to Huntsville, Athens, Alabama.
Yo, you watching BluntRapsTV.
Geo. Yeah.
It had to come around in Alabama. Everybody else had their time. Texas, Georgia, you know what I'm saying, East Coast, West Coast, whatever. It had to come around in Alabama. That's where it all started at. For most black people in this country anyway, you know what I'm saying? Everybody got an aunt or somebody shit that's from Alabama, you know what I mean? So it had to make its way back around.
I mean, everybody on the rise right now, to me, from Alabama, man, you know what I mean? We ain't the only one doing it. We the only one doing the international, but there's a couple more people back home, man, putting the city on too.
We appreciate it. We went hard to make sure that it was a good cohesive piece of work, and it's still not even our best work yet. So it's much appreciated, but we take it with a grain of salt and keep on moving and keep trying to get better for real. My dude Zach describes it best. He said, from zero to hero. You know what I mean? You go over there and you go from playing clubs with just a couple people in the States or with a lot of people and everybody's just kind of looking at you awkward to going over halfway across the world and everybody knows every lyric to every song. Shit's amazing. Inspiring.
Freak, but I see what it did for my career, so I'm down with it.
They got two boys from Huntsville, Alabama, doing shows overseas and all across the country, so kudos, internet. It sets us apart, you know what I'm saying? The fact that people don't go in to make dope albums, everybody wants to make a single. Us taking that format that we grew up on and taking those records we grew up on, it just made sense. It was natural. And then us doing that instead of putting out a hot single, once again, takes us out of the rat race. You know what I mean? You're not looking to us for that. You know what you're going to get when you get a Slow Motion Sounds project.
Yeah, I think it make a lot of people proud, man. I actually had somebody come to the barbershop and tell me that. Like, they can't believe the people don't stick to the script and making albums no more. Like, people don't tell stories. They don't hear that no more. And they couldn't believe. They asked me, like, why the music change like that? I'm like, shit, I don't know. I mean, I know what we do. I don't know what everybody else do, you know what I mean? So
it's just the microwave age. Everybody wants everything fast, and they want it now. You know what I'm saying? So it only made sense for it to go to just being straight singles. And really, the industry's always been about singles. Singles to sell the albums. But nowadays, it's singles to sell the tours. You know what I mean? To sell the tickets.
I'm in the jungle dreaming, eyes open. Rethink the impossible, so I stop hoping. When I was in school, they used to call me daydreamer. Actuality turned the dream into a beamer. I'm looking every day, staring in the mirror. Eyes low from the kush, maybe reconsider. So they tell me that read about the past. If he died with his eyes open, I could tell that he was focused. Nightmares, hunger thoughts of being rich. If everything was vice versa, will I live like this? Walking by faith, never sight, that's my motto. Call themselves leaders when they know they should follow. They say if it wasn't no tomorrow, I can say that.
It's kind of unavoidable being a group, you know what I'm saying? You're always going to get compared to those that came before you because you got to have a reference point. And we appreciate being called outcasts because really, they're on the level that we're trying to reach, you know what I'm saying? They're not a regional act, internationally known superstars, you know what I'm saying? So that's what we're on. We've been doing this since 04, you know what I'm saying? It's always a team thing. Between us and the block beaters, and when we all get in there and put all our minds together, then we create something real nice. And we've been doing it for so long that it's kind of easy now. You know what I'm saying? We worked out the kinks. CP knows what we sound best on. He knows how to break the beat for Clover's verse, or how to switch up the snares for my verse. You know what I'm saying? And it all came together to make a really, really good record.
You got a real team behind you?
Yeah, exactly. That's what makes us us. That's the G side. That's what the cohesive was all about. Some people got it confused and they didn't really know, but if you look at it, the whole album is full of features. It's full of big, lush production. That's what the one cohesive is about. A bunch of people working together to reach a common goal. Well, we got a lot of things we're working on. The next project, the next Slow Motion Sounds project, is going to be Christmas. It's a W2 Boy project. Should be out in like April. And another Drunk Before 9 is myself, Christmas and Bentley. And there should be another G-Side album before the end of the year. We're not going to reveal the title yet. We'll keep that under wraps. But yeah, be on the lookout. We have one before the end of the year.
I mean, everybody want to go mainstream, man, you know what I mean? So, I mean, we just hope we be successful, man, you know what I'm saying?
And we just want to stay relevant, really. Yeah. Stay relevant, stay working, you know what I mean? And being able to live off producing great quality music. Make sure you go check out G-Side, the one cohesive, iTunes, slowmotionsounds.com, a brand new video, Inner Circle, just dropped. Make sure you go check that out, YouTube, Vimeo, Hunts Vegas, the world, layout. Geographic and looking down at the earth from this airplane, you can see what God made.